Oh man. This is enormous. This whole area. What? Hey folks, and welcome back to After Work Gaming. We are back in Obduction, and two quick things. Just let me get my notes here, because I want to just give a little shout out to some users. User Toxuriel actually suggested I look behind this machine, which I'm going to do in a second. So thank you for the tip. And then Eliguru Wellesley actually knows the lore better than I do, because I went back and I listened to the notes that we found in Farley's house. I went back to the video, the Hunrath history video. And first off, this planet is called Kaptar. So let's just stop calling. I'm going to stop calling it the Arai homeworld, or the Arai planet. And these ruins were built by a race that worshipped the Arai. And then the machines were built by another race that actually used the Arai as bait to hunt some sort of sky creatures, or some sort of flying creatures. So thank you both for pointing those things out. Let's take a look behind this machine here. Zenyamatsa? I feel like that's misspelled, but okay. Zenyamatsa? Fine. Bessmyslenym delom. Okay, well, that's a useful tip, because I would have spent way, way, way too much time messing around with this machine. Essentially, what that phrase means is go ahead and engage in senseless tasks, or basically, this is the red herring machine for now. Maybe it'll become useful. I'm going to guess not, given what's written on the back. I think this is just it's a troll box. Okay. All right, well, that doesn't really leave us with too much. Except, let's just... the path forward seemed to be to engage the rotors down here. So let's just go ahead and engage the rotors, right? This like, crankshaft thing. Let's just go ahead. Does this seem to get it moving, at least? Okay. It's now working. Let's see, maybe something else has changed. Maybe the machine is now, like, lit. Wow. This has definitely changed. This was not rotating when we saw it last time. And I think it's going down. I think it's like corkscrewing in. Oh man. Yeah. I would have spent way, way, way too much time just messing around with that. But hold on. At the same time... At the same time, there's a staircase up there, so it can't be... completely nonsense, right? I mean, this is a ladder that would come down. Alright, we'll deal with that when we get there. Which way would that go? And then it would go up here, and then it would go there. Now, the one thing I thought about, by the way, for the red... So I thought about two things when we were offline. So for the red beam, I think the red beam, because it did the same thing in Hunrath, it would just allow us to walk through the... Hold on. Whoa. Okay, so we can use this. Huh. Point it at these, and... Oh! Oh, here we go. Can we engage them all? Yes, we can. Is that gonna, like, mess us up? Necessarily, I guess. I mean, the crankshaft should be powerful enough. Can we disengage? Oh, it is a disengage. Hmm. Okay, well, let's see. It may be that, like, maybe this overloads the... Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Hello. So now that we've got this moving, maybe we can move that thing down by where we first encountered the temple, right? But... I suspect, so here's what I was going to say about the red beam. So, in Hunrath, when we took down the red beam, we can move through the membrane, right, of the cell. And so we're in a different cell now, so we have to make the membrane permeable again. So that's why we have to take down the red beam. That machine. And if we do, I suspect what we're going to have to do, what we're going to be able to do is take that cart and ride it down that set of chains and back to this set of chains, maybe. First, Okay, see, this is now rotating, right? Now all rotating. Thank God for invisible walls. I would have fallen off the bridge here. Let's see what's down there, yeah? We saw there's a platform down there. Very cool. Okay. The other thing I thought of was... Remember... That's what's down here. This is a way to get to this machine. All the more reason, by the way, that I think maybe. Yeah. Okay. So, like, as I was saying, all the more reason why I think maybe it's going to be a permeable membrane. So this actually works out to our benefit. So let's run to the... There we go. Let's run to the temple entrance. As I was saying, since we're in... when we saw the map on the inside... Whoops, I forgot to rotate it. There's a map on the inside of the shack in Hunrath, which apparently is a map of this cell. And I thought, if you remember from last episode, there was like a red dot, and I'm like, oh, maybe that red dot is where we were. My suspicion, actually, is that if it's a cell, these are all oriented in a particular way. Okay? And... Those sounds are a little creepy. I think maybe we can look at the map and sync up locations for example, the machines, where the... I think the red dot is probably an indication of where... Now, the history didn't actually explain where the cave paintings came from, but I'm assuming maybe it's the same guys who made this temple. I was going to say, we can probably sync up the locations. I think the red dot is probably where they used to take the ambassador seed that would bring new arrivals to Hunrath. Oh, and that's moving now. Perfect. Perfect. Let's see if we could just ride this, right? But first, what is happening up here? Because remember, there was like a little mechanism that we can look at. Like here. Right? And this isn't moving. And I don't know what this is. It's a strange contraption. But it seems like there is... It seems like there would be something else to go here, right? Because there seems to be another wheel or a cog or something. Alright, so let's come down. Let's see if we can take that little... well, it's not really little, right? But let's see if we can take this... this cart somewhere. Or do something with it. Is there any control? No. Okay, well, not as straightforward as I had thought, but okay. Oh, hold on. This is just a bit of lore, but I see. So the purple stuff is what this. These are what the banners are made out of. Very cool. That also explains why they're everywhere around here. Okay. Well. Let's see. Now down there. Right? Down there is just a path to the lower levels here. To where the cart, to like below where the cart is, right? So if we vacate this area, if we move this cart out, we'll be able to come up there, and then go up that staircase and go to that side of whatever this place is actually called, right? Now I suspect... that we have to move that arm into place here in order to move the cart, right? How to do that at the moment, I'm not sure. Let's go back around to this. Right, because that going up the stairs there just result in me coming back to the other machinery. That goes around there somehow. Huh. Check that out. There's a path there. Can I go there? That looks like a path. That I could travel, potentially. keep that in mind for a sec. Let's see. Nothing's turning here. This isn't turning, right? It's basically just turning through. Now this would move the chain links, right? Why is it not turning? Is it because the barnacles are on it? It could very well be. We may have to get rid of these barnacles. It also may be possible that I don't actually need to get rid of that at all. Alright, so we found a way. Okay, so we found, let's just reassess real quick. We found a way to get a cart to the red beam. We should probably do that regardless, just because that seems to be the one thing we can do for sure. Is there any way here that I can go back there? No. No. Just make sure that there's no way around. I mean, this is going to take us back to where we were. We're walking away from the machinery now. Right? Because now we're going to come back to this big secondary piece of machinery. Yeah, the staircase is just going to loop us around. Yes. Well, if push comes to see, there's another one of these arms. And again, this thing is not turning. And again, there's a walkway. Interesting. So, can we see, I mean, maybe we can take a look at how this is mirrored. But you know what's possible? You know what's possible. What's possible is that if these chains go through the membrane, and the membrane isn't permeable, then they wouldn't move, right? Because the membrane's not letting anything pass through, and the chain links would have to pass through. So let's, what's going on? Oh yeah, that's the crankshaft. Okay, let me run back to the machine that swaps out with the piece of Hunrath that has, that's an interesting little plateau there. I wonder how much of this I can explore, because there's more staircases there. This may be a little bit more convoluted than I'm making this seem, because it may be that the chains don't actually link up quite as easily as I thought. It may be that I don't necessarily ride the cart there and then come out up there. But that's not our point, right? The point for us at the moment is, yeah, I also don't know what is or is not a red herring here, you know what I'm saying? Okay, yes. So let's ride the cart, let's get the cart so that we can turn this off. And let's go back to the main machine, or the main, right, the main spot where we came in originally into Kaptar, which is the elevated junkyard space. While I'm running there, just one more thought that had occurred to me, sort of thinking through what these things are and how the spheres work. Alright, this sphere is interesting. But it occurred to me, you know, remember we couldn't, or I couldn't, explain what the purpose of the sphere in the center of Hunrath was, the one that has like motorcycles attached to it that you can then turn around and rotate. Well, the thought occurs that if you remember from the sphere that's right next to the red beam, not every sphere has a machine. Right, the one that we're about to run to, there are machines on both ends, meaning there's a machine in the sphere that, right. There is a machine regardless of what version of the sphere you're in, right? There's the Hunrath one has a sphere, and also the one that has the cutouts. That's the one that's in Hunrath now, the one that we originally used. It also has a machine like this. Right. Go back to Hunrath. But the one next to the red beam back there, only the actual Hunrath space, the space with the shack, has a machine, has a seed machine. The piece of, I guess, Kaptar that was originally what we saw behind the schoolhouse that then got swapped in that we were just looking at that doesn't have a machine. So that got me thinking that maybe, and I'm putting money down on this, and by money I mean I'm just making a gentleman's guess here, that rotating mechanic is going to be something. It's probably going to be out of this world because it looks like a Kaptar, a piece of the Kaptar temple. But I think we're going to end up in a swapping situation where we're going to have to swap, rotate the sphere around, and swap again. That's just my guess. I could be totally wrong, but I think it's a pretty decent guess. Well, and that closed up. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to hightail it back to downtown Hunrath, and I'm just going to cut it. Yeah, I'm going to go this way. I'm just going to cut the whole running sequence, because you guys really don't need to be bothered seeing me basically leg it all the way down there. I will see you basically when I get to the cart, so that we can then pull it back over there. All right, I'll see you guys in a couple of seconds. All right, hey folks. So we're back at the cart. It is exactly where we left off, where we left it rather. Get in now, please. Thank you. It's right at that entrance where we took down the. Let's turn this off and let's just go back. So it's where we had taken out and cleared out the first real membrane path that got us to. Where did it get us? Oh, it got us, I think, onto the wall. No, it got us to the junkyard. I'm being silly. Alright, so remember, we are going to have to navigate these switches a little bit, and I figured, you know, that's something we can do and still, you know, talk about it. So, come on. There we go. Now we have to get behind what I have been routinely calling now the schoolhouse. You know, I don't know if it is the schoolhouse, I'm guessing that it is. I don't know about half these other paths, that's the only thing. And I'm assuming that maybe we'll figure out what it's for eventually. Now, here we are. We're behind the house, and can we, oh wow, we can trigger it from here? From inside the cart? This is like a drive-through swap. Let's do it. Okay. And exactly as expected, the cart is within the sphere that's about to be swapped. Let's go. And I don't know how this is going to function, honestly, because my recollection is when this sphere, when this Hunrath piece was in Kaptar, it was impossible to go to the red beam. You were just seeing it through a window. Okay. So we are literally right here. And the machine to swap is right here. How did we get... This is confusing. I thought it was... Maybe there's a button on either side. Maybe that's what's going on. But I recall their button being on that side, because obviously we were looking at the map. And here's what I'm talking about. So if you can kind of see... I'm kind of trying to angle the camera. So this red dot right here, I'm thinking that's not representing where we are, although it might, now that I look at it again, but it might represent where we first came into Hunrath, actually. All right, so let's back it up. Let's flip on the cart. No, stop it. Okay. And aim it up a little bit there, and go. There we go. And of course, now the color is blue, right? Okay. So let's switch this cart back here. Now the question is, we've opened up the membranes, and what does that do for us? Because I'm really not seeing that move either. Yes, yes. But I'm still hearing a noise. Now, we can't move from here anyway, so let's just go ahead and swap back. And what I'm going to do is to avoid the, wasting all of your collective time. What I'm going to do is once we flip back into Hunrath, I'm just going to cut it to the point where I'm going to run back to the upper junkyard. Now that I'm thinking about it. Sorry, I'm not going to cut anything. I'm going to get out of the cart. I'm going to run to the tree. Because what if the door is open now? Maybe that's what's happening. Maybe I can go through the door now. Okay, let's, No. Let's go over here. Alright, so we're swapped back. That's a thought. What if the doors were only locked? You know, they were impenetrable because we... Remember, we got the sound of... Let's get out. We got the sound of, oh, you can't pass through this membrane, right? So now the membrane's down. Now let's go under the tree and see what's going on. That's actually a thought. Maybe we can go through and maybe that'll give us access to a different area where we don't have to worry about that, you know, that very, very strange machinery. Remember, there might be a slight load here, so if I have to cut it, I will. But for now, it doesn't seem like it. Just a couple of graphical stutters as we load up this area. There we are. Okay. Now the blue door, I believe, is this one. No, it still looks pretty bad. Yeah, it still looks pretty bad. Alright, so... So now I am going to cut it. We're going to go back to Kaptar. I'm going to go to the upper junkyard. I'm going to swap myself in again. And then we are... I mean, we're going to see what else has changed. Because now, obviously, we've taken down the membrane. So maybe there's something else happening. And this loading screen is as good a time as any. I will see you guys in a couple of minutes, I guess, in Kaptar. Alright, folks, we're back in Kaptar. We just swapped in. There's the bridge. Let's actually go see what's happening up there. Because maybe the links are working now? I don't know. They weren't when we turned off the red beam. Let's see. A little bit of a graphical stutter. I apologize for that, but this is kind of a huge space, I'm assuming. Here we go. The other reason, by the way, that I want to go there is it. I mean, it is a mirror image of the main temple area. So maybe we'll see something other than the power. Obviously, that crankshaft goes there. This one powers those machines. That one powers whatever this is. This looks like another descending basket, and that goes off somewhere. I'm gonna bet that that one powers the other set of chains. Gonna guess. Alright. Those aren't moving either, and we can't go up there because that ladder has to get disengaged. But that's connected to the Russian mechanism. Okay. I'm not touching that Russian mechanism until we figure out later what any of that stuff means. Let's see. There's these, like, other platform areas that I don't know if I can reach. I kind of wish I could. Or I kind of suspect that I probably could, because, you know, why tease me with those areas that I can't get to? Then again, tease me with those areas because that's what the temples look like, right? And that can't move. I really do suspect it might be because of the barnacle buildup. Okay, let's go take a look at what there is that's left after we took down the red beam. Maybe there's like, I don't know, something under the red beam. But I suspect probably not. No, it's just CW's device. I think it's CW's device. Why would he want the membranes not to be permeable? You know what? I really don't know. Okay, well, there's really only one thing left now. So, the membrane is permeable, right? And if the membrane is permeable, that means we need to be able to, or we should be able to, jump through the membrane somewhere else. And if you see that that I'm heading towards the bridge, it's because that's the only place that I can think of here where we tried to go through the membrane, or thought that we might be able to go through the membrane. So I'm going to go back to the bridge and we're going to see what's going on. The only problem is, if we think about it like this. If we turn the bridge, disengage the cursor, if we turn the bridge this way, right, that rotates away, this is the membrane, this is the only part of the membrane we ever tried to cross. This piece rotates away here, this piece of bridge rotates there. We can't. Now of course, this, wait a minute. I was going to say, this beam is in the way of our bridge, rotating again this way so that we line up even more with this membrane, but... Well. Very sneaky. There we go. And lo and behold, the membrane. Now let's see what we can see. This should have another... Yeah. Okay. Moving through. Got a green color. That's pretty neat. And lo and behold, this is the area that I was, like, lamenting that I couldn't go to, I think. Let's see what's over here. A lot of nothing. You know, a lot of stuff to give me vertigo. Another set of chains, and I think that's the main temple. Hmm. Oh, whoa. Birds. Cool. There's nowhere else to go but here. Maybe. So this doesn't have barnacle buildup, you see? Maybe this will show us how to engage the chains. Oh. This doesn't have barnacle buildup, so we can... See? Yeah, see? This winds us up as we go. And this will put us above... This is interesting. This will put us above the basket that we were trying to get out of the way. What does this do for us is my question. Interesting. And by interesting, I mean... Not very interesting. I'm actually quite, Can we do anything with the basket down here? Doesn't look like there is anything down there anymore. Because we moved it! We caused it to move! Okay, let's go. Right? Yes, it's now free and clear. Okay, so. Yes, I know, and so I know we're getting close to the end of, you know, like a normal episode length here. In fact, I'm getting my little silent buzzing alarm here. But, man, I gotta know. Don't you guys have to know? What is on the other side? Because we've worked for this a little bit now. Let's go find out. Well, obviously, we can come up down here. We know that there is a staircase leading up. Go all the way up now. And hit the next set of puzzles. Something like this. Whoa. That looks like a swap. That looks like something you can swap. Hold on. Barnacles. Okay, so, hold on. This takes us onto platform. A platform area. That leads all the way up there. See this? This was a sphere, right? So this is a sphere that got swapped around. With other Arai. Are they different, you think? Because they're like, these are green, there are blue, and then we saw orange ones elsewhere. Oh man. This is enormous. This whole area. What? What? What are these? And they're the hooks. So this is what they were hunting. Remember we talked about in the beginning of the episode that they were using the Arai as bait for something? They were using the Arai as bait for these guys. Dang. I guess this is kind of cryptic, but I'm assuming this is like blood, I guess? Or whatever these guys had in them. Whoa. And well, there's nothing going down here. And old man Ashevitz here. And this is another. That's right, this is another membrane. Okay. Okay, well, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna leave off. See? The orange, right? And there were green ones and there were blue ones. I guess maybe there are different types of Arai or different, like, you know, like a solitary evolution, right? They're all Arai, but they're different. They're like Darwin's finches. Okay. So, we accomplished quite a lot. We have now opened the membrane, and we are now into the whole nonlinear thinking as to Kaptar. I gotta tell you. This area is immense. Like, not only is it just, you know, oh, you're in a junkyard, or you're in whatever, but you saw there was like a little prayer circle down there or something? Something weird like that. Nope, there's nothing down here. I'm gonna run around just a little bit more, because I'm just dying for curiosity here. Right, we came out, we came out on the other end from there. This would lead us to. This would lead us. This area would probably lead us to that area we saw from up there. Sort of slopes off around this other mechanism. Right? We were saying, like, oh, can we go here? Oh, wait a minute. No, that's not the tree, that's just limbs. That? I think that's communication, or attempts at communication. Oh man. Okay, last path to check, and then we'll be done with this place. Or not. I mean, I'm finding stuff. Door? There's a door. This kind of looks like one of the doors in Unrath. Okay. I take back what I said about there being one more place to check. There are plenty of places to check here. A lot of checking to do, and I think this is blocked. Right? Right. Okay. So when we come back next time, I think we'll continue exploring. We'll check out what's beyond. But that's what these things are. It's probably these sky whales or whatever are those things that were being hunted. But when we come back, we'll continue exploring this place. We'll find out what's beyond the membrane on that side. And yeah, we'll just try and find a way to the tree. Not the least of which is, I want to find a way down there, right? Look at that. Yep, there's a seed swap, or there's, it looks to be like something down there. It may not be a seed swap machine, but there's definitely lore. I'm seeing scraps of paper. And, scale. Whatever. Okay. Anyway, if you guys like this episode, like, comment, subscribe. If you guys think I'm overlooking something, if you think I should be doing something differently, or just otherwise have constructive criticism, by all means, leave a comment. Everything is welcome. And in any case, I will see you all next time. I
Rather than